Welcome back, warriors, to my channel, guys. Today I got another Diablo 3 video for you, and we're breaking down the Wizard ARCHON BOOM set. Let's get into it. All right, we're going to be breaking down this class. It is the Archon Boom Boom Build, as I call it. The Wizard has been one of my favorite classes in Diablo 3. I felt like it's been a little underpowered, but since I've been playing this Archon class, it's been a lot of fun. So we're going to break down all the gear that you need, all the skills, all the Paragon levels, and then some strategy at the end to show you how to play the build. Let's jump right into it. So the first thing that you're going to need is the entire six-piece Veer set. Okay, you need all six pieces, and I know what you're asking yourself, like, well, what about the ring, you know, that allows me to just use one less? No, in this particular build, you're going to need all six, and I'm going to tell you why. But first, let's go over the set abilities. Two, this entire class is all about Archon, guys. So two set, Archon gains the effect of every rune, which we'll touch on in a little bit. Four-piece set is Archon stacks also increase your attack speed, armor, and resistances by 1%. This is very important. The six-piece set, you gain one Archon stack when you are hit with an Archon ability, and Archon stacks also reduce the damage you take by 0.15% and have their damage bonus increase to 100%. So, as you can see, we're doing everything Archon in this build. So, let's break down the gear. Okay, we're going to go into gear, and I'm going to tell you why we're going to do gear first over skills, because there's a few pieces in here that I would say that is 100% recommended for the class. So first, we're going to break down the helmet. Okay, helmet, you're going to want intelligence, armor, crit with reduced cooldown. The armor chest piece, you're going to want intelligence, vitality, armor with cold resist. Third piece is shoulders. You're going to want intelligence, resist, life, and then gold, or make sure you get the reduced cooldown. We want reduced cooldown on almost everything that you can get it on, because we want to be able to stay in Archon almost non-stop. Okay, there is going to be that small moment when you're outside of Archon, but you want to be in Archon as much as possible. That's where this build thrives. Okay, so gloves, you're going to want intelligence, crit chance, crit damage, along with fire resist. Any of the resistances can be whatever you want, but you also want the reduced cooldown. Then belt, this is, we're gonna go over the six piece first. Veers, the pants, you're gonna want intelligence, life per second, and then cooldown. I need to change my spectral blade to probably vitality. We haven't done that yet, but it can definitely just be vitality. Boots, intelligence, vitality, armor, and then movement speed. The movement speed is good, but it can be something else. All right, now let's get into the two pieces that are very, very important. So you definitely recommend, you have to have the Fenzulas and Probable Chain. Why? Because you automatically start with 45 Archon stacks when entering Archon form. For the belt, you do want intelligence, vitality, resist, and life. You want to be as tanky as possible, because the Wizard is very, very squishy. Okay, outside of Archon form is very scary. She's very squishy. But you start with 45 Archon stacks. This maxes out at 50. I wish that my belt would have been a little bit better, but you max out at 50 stacks, but mine is only 45. So you want to have this belt, because then when you transform into Archon, you're automatically starting with 45 stacks on top of all that set bonus. So all the attack speed, armor, resist, and the damage reduction and damage increase is all already 45 stacks, that 45% stack higher, okay? Next, for the amulet, you want the Traveler's Pledge to go along with the ring, which is the Compass Rose. This combo pairs very, very well. So while you're moving with the Wizard, you're doing reduced damage. And then while you're standing still, you're doing increased damage, okay? Which is very, very important. Now, if you want to opt out and not use the Traveler's Pledge, I really do like the Flavor of Time. Although this one is not as good as my Traveler's Pledge. But the Flavor of Time is actually really, really good to help add that reduced cooldown of all skills. Okay, now we got the Compass Rose. Oh, and on that amulet, guys, you're going to want vitality, life, crit chance, or crit damage, life per second. Okay, then we go down to the Compass Rose. You're going to want intelligence, vitality, life, crit damage, cold resist. Okay, and then the other ring, you want Convention of Elements. This is great because it just swirls all the different elements. You get the increased damage with it. Right, you get the increased 181% increased damage to a single element for 4 seconds as it rotates through. This is very, very important for the Wizard, because we're using a few different elements here. This is a cold based build, so you're going to be using a lot of cold damage in Archon, but you're also using a lot of fire and electricity as well. So having Convention of Elements helps boost your damage even more. Now in the rings, we have the Bane of the Stricken. Each attack you make against an enemy increases damage it takes from your attacks, and then you gain the 25% increased damage against bosses and Rift Guardians. This is really good for solo pushing. And then in the other one, you want the Gaduck or Goduck of Swiftness. You gain swiftness with every attack, increasing your attack speed by 1% and dodge by 0.78% for 4 seconds. This stacks 15 times. And then once you have it to 25 or higher, you get 1% cooldown reduction per stack, which is huge because then that helps you with your Archon form that much more. Okay. And then you gain 181 increased damage for a single element with the Convention of Elements. Next is the Bracers. I chose the Nemesis Bracers. In this slot is really up for debate. You could use the Blood Bracers. Those are really, really, really good to help you increase that potency of your shield by 100%. But if you want, use the Nemesis Bracers. I think they're really good. You're going to want Intelligence, Vitality, Resist All, Life Per Second. Okay, that does it for our gear. Let's move over to the skills. All right, in skills, this is the one where I've had the most trouble picking. I see a lot of Arcane Torrent, Ray of Frost, a lot of Arcane Torrent static discharge is really, really good. It just allows each missile to explode into two piercing bolts that hit additional targets, which helps you charge your Archon ability. So this one's really, really good. I just feel like it just doesn't do enough for me. So like when you're using it, I just feel like it's just so weird when I'm using it. So I opted for Disintegration with Convergence, or you could do Chaos Nexus. Intensify is also good, but either one of these is good. You just want a resource spending attack because this is going to help you boost the cooldown of Archon. Next up, we have Black Hole Absolute Zero. This is really, really good because we're doing a cold build. So each enemy hit increases the damage of your cold spells by 5 seconds for 5% for 10 seconds. So you fire this out there into a big mob after you come out of Archon form, hit it, it boosts your cold damage, and then you transform back into Archon and you have a huge boost. So when you start blasting off with the Archon Wave of Force ability. So this is really, really good. Sometimes I don't use this because I'll get into the our powers later in the cube for the real reason why, but this is a really good way to boost that damage. Next up, we have Energy Armor. Energy Armor with Force Armor. Incoming attacks that would deal more than 35% of your maximum life are reduced to deal 35% of your maximum life instead. The amount absorbed cannot exceed 100% of your life. What this means is that if you were to take almost a one-shot, it just reduces it down to 35% of your maximum life instead. But if you are really, really low on life, then, well, too bad. You're lights out. Next up for me is Teleport. I use Wormhole. Wormhole is really good if you need to get out of a sticky situation. After you're casting Teleport, you have 3 seconds to cast one more for free. The reason I like this one is because, again, you're so squishy outside of Archon form that sometimes you need to get away, let your Arcane build, and then shoot, and then come back into Archon form. So I like Wormhole. You could apt for Calamity to stun people as you go away. But either one of those is really good. I just like Wormhole for the additional getaway. Next, we have Force Weapon with Deflection. When you perform an attack, gain a protective shield for 3 seconds that absorbs 4% of your life. This is very important. Make sure you have this skill, guys. This just helps you be a little bit more tanky and absorb a little bit more damage and be able to fight a little bit longer outside of Archon form. And then, of course, we have Archon, the main ability of the show. Now, in the set, you gain the ability of every single rune. Now, the key here is the rune that you select is going to be the damage that you do. So we opted for Slow Time. Okay, Archon abilities deal cold damage instead, which pairs well with our Black Hole ability. Right here, right? Black Hole. Nice little duo. Now, if you don't want to use Black Hole and you want to use something else like Explosive Force is really good, then change it to fire, you know, a lightning damage is really good. You can do either one, but I've opted for the slow time just to be able to have the additional cold damage against enemies. Now, your passives. This one I keep going back and forth on. You can use Gavilizing Ward, which as long as you haven't taken damage in the last 5 seconds, you gain a protective shield that absorbs 60% of your life. This is really good if you're just standing in place, teleporting around, and you're not really taking damage. It just gives you an additional shield so you don't take any damage, but you could opt out for Blur to decrease teleportation, or decrease teleportation, decrease damage, guys. Or you could do elemental exposure. So this stacked on top of your ring convention of elements. This is going to help do even more damage if you want, if you feel like you're lacking in damage. I like the shield just because, again, I feel so squishy outside of Archon mode. Next up, obviously, evocation. Reduce cooldowns by 20%. Very important. Audacity, you deal 30% additional damage to enemies within 15 yards. Very important. When you're in Archon, you're just going to be bouncing around, hitting wave of force. So you're going to be doing a lot of damage in close quarters. And then, of course, unstable anomaly. When you die, come back to life. Okay, we know that one. That does it for our skills, guys. Let's go over to our Paragon points. All right, Paragon points. In core, you want to start with movement speed and intelligence, then vitality into maximum arcane power. Offense, you want cooldown reduction, crit chance, crit damage into attack speed. Defense, you want resist all, armor, life, then life regen. And then utility, you want resource cost reduction, life per hit, area damage, then gold find. All right, now let's look at the Kanaya's Q powers. Okay, we're using the furnace, guys. Increase damage against elites by 50%. This is very important. We want to just take those elites down. No big deal. And then the other one that steals the show, this is a must required item. Both of these is the Swami, which the bonuses from Archon stacks now last for 20 seconds after Archon expires. And then Obsidian Ring of the Zodiac. The remaining cooldown of one of your skills by 1 second when you hit with a resource spending attack. And that's why we don't have a resource generating attack. All we're using is Disintegrate, or you could be using Arcane Torrent to help use Obsidian Ring of the Zodiac. All right, now let's get into how to play this build. Okay, guys, the reason that we're using this build is because of Chantoto's Will and Force. The reason we're using these is because of the 2-set bonus that comes with it. Every second while in Archon, you expel a wave of destruction, dealing 4,000% weapon damage to enemies within 30 yards. The damage scales with attack speed, which is why we have the Gaydock of Swiftness on our ring and some attack speed bonuses on our other gear. And then every time you hit within an attack while not in Archon form, 4,000% weapon damage is added to the wave of destruction, stacking up to 20 times. So what this means is that every single time that you're attacking with an ability or a basic attack, your resource spending attack, black hole, outside of Archon form, you can get a stack up to 20 to help increase your damage going into Archon form. Now for Enchantoto's Will, you're going to want cold damage because this is a cold build. Build, intelligence, vitality, crit damage. Put the socket in there with the crit damage. And then reduce cooldown, maximum arcane. And then for Chantoto's Force, you want damage, intelligence, crit chance. The crit hits and grants 4 arcane power is really nice, but that should be changed to another, should be vitality is what it should be. And then reduce cooldown. So the basic idea here is when you're going up to a mob of enemies, you fire off a black hole if you want, fire off a black hole, shoot your resource spending attack, mine in my case is disintegrate, let that counter get up to as close as possible to 20, hit Archon form, you hit with 45 stacks, you're going to bounce around in Archon form. I like to teleport while smashing just my square button, which is just my wave of force for Archon, and you're just going to keep doing this until Archon goes away. You're going to try to get those stacks as high as possible until Archon ends. Once it ends, those stacks stay on you for 20 seconds outside of Archon form, and by that, however much you have left until Archon is back up to use, you should be able to use it with the Obsidian Ring of the Zodiac, and then on top of the Gaydock of Swiftness, that should help you with all your resource or with all of your your cooldowns. Archon should be back up. You shouldn't have to be out of Archon for very, very long. So, and you just rinse and repeat. This build is very, very fun to use. Bouncing around in Archon form, just emitting waves of force constantly is absolutely just so much fun. It deals so much power. The power level on it is really, really good. I don't think it's going to be able to push high GRs, but the build is very, very fun. It's very good for wizard mains. It's very good just to be using in solo builds. In group builds, I would move it just a little bit more, but the build will be down in the description, guys. But yeah, that's all you do. I like to use, my basic attacks, use cold, black hole, get those counters up, go into Archon form, and then immediately when you go into Archon form, throw up your slow time. That should always be on. That should never be off. Then just bounce around hitting all these mobs with your wave of force. And when you get out, make sure you play kind of like a defensive retreat. Use your ability, resource spending ability. Everything should make Archon come right back up. rinse and repeat, guys. This build is very, very fun to use, and I hope you guys let me know down in the comments what you think about the build. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure to drop a like. That really does help me out. If you guys are new here, be sure to subscribe and join the Warriors so you guys don't miss out on future tips and tricks videos for Diablo 3. And for me, Warlug, as always, guys, stay gaming. Catch you in the next one. Peace.